everyone, welcome to this episode of the Witcher 3 REDkit Tutorial series. My name is Martin Kocian and I'm going to introduce the file and project handling of the REDkit. I created this diagram to demonstrate how the file system is designed and I will explain these elements separately. First of all, for creating a mod you will need all the original game assets, which will be contained in the read-only depot. From now on I will just call this depot. We wanted to manage the installation size of the product, so we decided to extract some of the assets from your Witcher 3 game installation. These will go into the Ankh depot directory, and we bundle the rest of the data with the REDkit itself. This will be in the R4Data directory. So now the question is, how can you set up these two physical directories? When you first start REDkit, you will be prompted the first time setup dialog. In this, you need to set your game installation path and your desired uncooked depot directory. When you click generate, it will start extracting the files, which will take a while, around 30 to 60 minutes depending on your hardware, but you only need to do this once. These files are all read-only, so you cannot modify them inside REDkit, and we suggest not to modify them outside of the REDkit either, because later this can cause issues. Moving to the other part of the file system, which is your own mod project. For this, you will need to set up a writable workspace. Now let's get back to the Wacom dialog. When you finish generating your depot, you can just click continue and you will be prompted to create project dialog. For your new project, you will need to set a name and a location. This location will be the physical directory of your writable workspace. You can have multiple projects on your system, but you are only allowed to work on one at a time. You can get back to this project later anytime you want. These will be always listed in the recent projects. But if for some reason you cannot find your projects, you can just click browse and search for it manually on the file system. Now for the tutorial, I already created an empty project, so I will just open the asset browser. Let's say you would like to create new quests, import external assets like meshes and textures. So for this, you can just right-click and create. This way you will see a huge amount of engine assets. And for the tutorial, I'm just gonna create a new quest file. You can see that this file will have this little plus icon, which indicates that this is added to your workspace. The read-only depot files will have this lock icon, which indicates that you shouldn't edit these. If I right-click and show in Explorer, the workspace directory will be opened and you can see that the tutorial quest is already created on the file system. For structuring your mods, you can also create new directories from the asset browser. I will just call this tutorial dir. And again, I'm just gonna quickly create a quest. And if I go back to the Windows Explorer, I can see that the directory and the quest is also created. Now let's say that you would like to import some external assets, you can just create right-click and import. For this, I have a DDS file ready on my PC, and I will just import it. I will import this tutorial texture. Again, you can see that this is already created on the file system as well. Now let's say that you would like to modify some existing asset. For this, you can just right-click and check out. During this operation, the depot file will be copied to your workspace and the read-only flag is removed. So if I go back to the file system again, you can see that this file is copied here. The checked out files will have a different icon. You can see this little green arrow. And the edit files will have the little red plus. If you made something by mistake, you can always just revert your file from the workspace by right-click and revert. This will completely delete the file from the workspace directory. As you can see, it's already gone. I can do the same for add data sets. Just revert, and it is already deleted. So be careful here, because if you revert a file, the physical directory, the file will be deleted also from the physical directory. So no way to get back the file after this point. Now let's move on to some other file system operations. For example, copy-paste. You can copy any of the files in the asset browser and paste them as well. Let's paste this here. And as you can see, the file will have the plus icon, which means it is added to the workspace. And again, if I open the workspace, you can see the file is already created. You can also rename the workspace file. I right-click rename. I will just call this real again. This also has the effect on the file system. You can see that the file is already renamed. For now, I will just revert this file as well. You won't be able to rename the read-only files naturally, and you also cannot rename checked-out files, because these are tied to a depo file. So you can see there is no option for renaming. I will revert this file as well. So as you can see, in the asset browser, you only see one directory, but in reality, there are three underlying physical directories which are integrated seamlessly. And moving on to the last step of creating a demand, which is the publish process. In REDkit, you can click publish and save and publish mod project. For this, you will need to set project name, version, some description, and the thumbnail. For now, I'm just going to quickly set some random thumbnail. So now I filled out all the necessary information for my mod project. I can just click Next and start the cooking. This will again take a certain amount of time, depending on your computer and also the complexity of your mod project. So now that the cooking is finished, I click Next, and there are multiple options for extracting your mod. You can create a zip package, you can install directly to your game, and also you can publish to Steam Workshop. If I go back to the file system, you can see that there are a bunch of directories created next to the workspace. These will contain the cooked and packed mod, which is ready to be used with the game itself. So now that we have the overview of the file system, I would like to move on to some potential issues and a few ways of fixing these. So if your REDkit keeps crashing on startup or when loading a file, or when playing on the level, these usually indicate asset corruption. There are three different options. There might be a corrupted asset in your uncooked depo, your R4Data directory, or in your workspace. First of all, for fixing your R4Data, you can use the storefront feature, which is verifying the integrity of your files. I can show this on Steam now. Under the installed files, you can see this button for verification. If you accidentally corrupted some file or deleted anything from the R4Data, this way it will be reacquired. If this didn't fix your issue, then you can always just redo the uncooking. For this, you can manually delete this directory and restart REDkit. At this point, you will be prompted the first time setup dialog again. You need to set up the path and generate again. For your workspace, we suggest to use some type of version control system, for example, Git. So if any of your files gets corrupted, you can just roll back to an earlier version and continue your work. If you don't have these, you can create a new project and add the files one by one until you find the corrupted. So if none of the above managed to fix your REDkit, then you can always use the report a bug button, which will take you to a website where you can fill out some description and attach the editor generated log files. So this was my introduction of the file and project handling. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to watch all the other tutorials as well. And as always, have fun creating mods.